Hi everyone. So in this video, we will talk about how we can flatten a JavaScript object. Okay. You might have already heard about flattening a nested array using array dot. Now we already have a method array dot prototype dot flat, and you just provide infinity there. It will flatten the nested array. Here, what we want in the output is, so after flattening this array, we should be getting this output. What this output is, this is the A is the parent object, right? A, you can say ABC, B has a nested ABC, ABD, ABE, ABF. Okay, sorry, AF, right? A has only F directly. So ABC, if you see ABC, ABD, ABE, and AF. This is actually a flattening of an object. So, and these object properties are separated with the forward slash. So how we can do this? Let's write a function, const flatten. It will have object as an input and the parent key. We'll talk about why parent key is required. Okay. And what we are going to do in this is we will just try to get the object.keys of this object. Let's get this more clear. Okay, this is our object and here we are trying to do the flatten. Okay, so what we are going to return from this is object.keys. So for object, we will get all the object.keys, which will give us an array. In array, you will get only single index, which is A. Okay. You will do a reduce. And reduce takes two arguments, accumulator and item. And this is initialized with empty object. Okay. Now, in this, what we are going to do is here we will check if this property is there or not in this object. So if object dot prototype dot has on property, we are doing dot call, we are just checking this object has this key or not, which will be like this is an object and the key is A right now. So this object will obviously have a key A. So we are inside this. Here we will get the value of this object using object key. And here now we will check if this is a further nested object or not. If this is a nested object, then we have to make a recursive call. So type of value. If type of value is object, or if it is an array, right? It can be array also, array dot is array. This value is representing an array. And value not equal to null. In that case, we will go inside this. Okay. And this is an object, so we have to iterate it again. And we have to call this flatten method by passing the value, which is an object or maybe an array, and the key. Okay. So here we will just check if flatten key, this parent key. If we are getting a parent key, then we have to run a loop onto this. Let I of, or let I in flat, right? Because flat is an object. Let k, and we'll just concat things here. We already got the parent key. Parent key forward slash dollar I. Then simply accumulator equal to flat. So this is like pretty much same. What we are doing is first we are getting the keys of the parent object, which is this. We have only single key. We are running a reduce function on this. and we are doing just checking object dot has on prototype, this object has this key or not. Okay, from this object we are passing directly, this object has this key or not. If yes, then we will get the value, and then we are checking if this value is an object or array or not. If this value is an object, not an array or not a null. I mean, array is also simple value, we don't need to iterate for that. We are iterating only if this value is an object and not null, then we are again calling this recursively, and from there we will get the flat value. If there is no parent key, initially it will not be a parent key, but when you call it recursively, then you will be passing the parent key. Here you are passing the key here, value and the key. Key is the parent, which is A. So the output of this is A, B, you can see A, B, C, A, B, D, A, B, E, and A, F, right? So A is the parent key for the first iteration. If parent key is there, then iterate onto the flat object, whatever we receive from the recursive call, and then just assign it and return the accumulator finally. So this is here, I can return accumulator so that this accumulator can be passed to the next iteration and we can get a single object. Okay, this is how we can actually flatten an object. Okay, thanks everyone.